Hi everybody, today we discuss tyrosine amino acid, tyrosine. So tyrosine is a non-essential amino acid. Tyrosine is a non-essential amino acid and it is formed from phenylalanine. Phenylalanine forms tyrosine. This tyrosine leads to the formation of epinephrine, norepinephrine, dopamine, and melanin. Epinephrine, norepinephrine, dopamine, melanin, and thyroid hormones. So tyrosine becomes more important because it leads to the formation of epinephrine, norepinephrine, dopamine, thyroid hormones and melanin. Okay, so coming to the cycle of tyrosine, which leads to the formation of epinephrine and norepinephrine and dopamine. So first we'll see the cycle, then it is easy to remember. Tyrosine, it will form dopamine. This dopamine will form norepinephrine and norepinephrine forms epinephrine. So the first point in this cycle to be remembered is that you remember the intermediates first. Tyrosine forms dopa, dopa forms dopamine, dopamine forms norepinephrine, norepinephrine forms epinephrine. If the intermediates and final product epinephrine is remembered, the cycle becomes easy. The first point is remembering tyrosine forms dopa, dopa forms dopamine forms norepinephrine, norepinephrine forms epinephrine. The second important point being dopa. The full form of dopa is dihydroxyphenylalanine. Dihydroxyphenylalanine. So this means that there has to be hydroxylation of tyrosine to form dihydroxyphenylalanine. So the enzyme is tyrosine hydroxylase. Because we require a hydroxylation reaction, so enzyme is tyrosine hydroxylase. All hydroxylation reactions generally require vitamin C, but here it will be requiring tetrahydrobiopterin, which forms dihydrobiopterin. Since it's a hydroxylation reaction, again it would be requiring oxygen. So tyrosine to dopa, hydroxylation reaction by tyrosine hydroxylase, tetrahydrobiopterin and oxygen are required. Now coming to dopa to dopamine. Dopa to dopamine is by a removal of carbon dioxide molecule. And important thing that it requires a pyridoxal phosphate. So carbon dioxide molecule is removed and it requires a pyridoxal phosphate. So the enzyme will be decarboxylase. Now coming to dopamine to norepinephrine. It is again a hydroxylation reaction. So it is hydroxylase. Now this hydroxylase reaction requires ascorbate to form dehydroascorbate. Again, because hydroxylation you require an oxygen, so oxygen will be required. So hydroxylation reaction, decarboxylation reaction, again hydroxylation reaction. Now coming to norepinephrine. So the important point over here is N for no methyl group. So norepinephrine has no methyl group, but epinephrine has methyl group. And as we have discussed, there is only one molecule, Mr. Sam. So Mr. Sam is the one which will give its methyl group. So the Mr. Sam is required in this reaction from norepinephrine to epinephrine. So Mr. Sam gives its methyl group from SH, S-adenosyl homocysteine. So S-adenosyl methionine is required, it forms S-adenosyl homocysteine. And finally we have the formation of epinephrine. So the enzyme, because there is a transfer of methyl, so the enzyme is methyl transferase. The enzyme is methyl transferase. Okay. So if we look at the enzymes, tyrosine forms DOPA in the presence of tyrosine hydroxylase because it is a hydroxylation reaction including bioptin. The DOPA forms dopamine and there is a decarboxylation reaction with the removal of carbon dioxide and it involves pyridoxal phosphate. Dopamine forms norepinephrine, it is again a hydroxylation reaction and as per the rule of hydroxylation reaction it follows and it uses vitamin C or ascorbate. Norepinephrine is not containing methyl group but epinephrine requires a methyl group. So Mr. Sam, that is S-adenosylmethionine and S-adenosylmethionine is important. It transfers its methyl group to norepinephrine, forms epinephrine and releases out S-adenosyl homocysteine. So the enzyme is methyl transferase. So this is the easiest method to remember the cycle. Just remember hydroxylation, decarboxylation, hydroxylation and methyl transferase reaction and it becomes easy. Mr. Sam plays an important role in transferring the methyl group. Now coming to the most important, norepinephrine is also important, epinephrine is also important. Dopamine also is important. It has function in locus ceruleus and substantia nigra. Substantia nigra and locus ceruleus. And locus ceruleus. So it is important for its certain activities, central nervous system activities that in substantia nigra and locus ceruleus. If there is decreased production of dopamine, it leads to Parkinson's disease. Okay. So if dopamine is not produced, it leads to Parkinson's disease. Now, if at all dopamine is not produced, then you want dopamine to be produced and therefore you give certain drugs so that dopamine is produced. Look at the diagram very carefully. If you require the production of dopamine, you could give a drug that is containing DOPA that will decarboxylate and produce dopamine, because as such dopamine cannot be given because it cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. So dopamine cannot cross the blood-brain barrier, therefore you have to give DOPA and DOPA will decarboxylate and form dopamine. So this is very clear, DOPA decarboxylates forming dopamine. But this decarboxylation will take place in all tissues and therefore the dopamine which is required at the specific place will be less. Therefore we have to give DOPA. DOPA decarboxylase has to be inhibited in other tissues and therefore carbidopa and methyl dopa are given. Okay, let's see it again. Let's see this reaction again. DOPA will form dopamine in the presence of decarboxylase. Okay. Okay, this dopamine cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. See, there is decreased production of dopamine in a disease called as Parkinsonism. Dopamine in Parkinsonism or Parkinson's disease. Now, you could have given dopamine directly, but dopamine cannot enter the blood-brain barrier. Because dopamine cannot enter the blood-brain barrier, I need to give DOPA. We need to give DOPA. So we give DOPA. DOPA decarboxylates and form dopamine. But this activity of DOPA to dopamine will take place in all tissues. And therefore, there will be less dopamine, therefore there will be less dopamine where it is required. And therefore we need to inhibit this DOPA decarboxylase also. So this DOPA decarboxylase is inhibited only in other tissues and inhibited in other tissues by giving carbidopa Okay, so Parkinsonism, again we'll see Parkinsonism what it is. The most important thing is that you need to give L-DOPA in Parkinson's. There is rigidity, tremor, central nervous system defects, stooping gait, loss of center of gravity. So rigidity, tremor, central nervous defects and stooping gait. So because there is decreased production of dopamine. And to increase the production of dopamine, you give L-DOPA, which will decarboxylate and form DOPA. But this is required only in the substantia nigra. This reaction is required only in the substantia nigra, but it will take place in all tissues. So we need to inhibit it in other tissues. Okay, so we give along with the carbidopa and methyldopa. That's all. Thank you for the tyrosine metabolism.